Well, I'm Tracy Haynes. I'm here at Appalachian State University in the Exercise Science Department. And
hi, I'm Grayson Johnson. I'm a student at Appalachian State University.
And we're just going to go through how to perform a seven-site skinfold measurement. And so we'll go over a couple different angles with how to actually take the measurements, a little bit with caliper etiquette. So first I'm going to start off with my caliper. And personally, I like the line calipers, and we'll show the differences with some of the other caliper options that we have. But personally for me, with a smaller hand, I can really handle the line a little bit better than some of the plastic larger calipers. Now these are typically made for somebody who's right-handed, so that you can hold it here with your thumb on the trigger, and then you're able to read the measurement here. If you're left-handed, it doesn't really work properly because you'd have to tilt your head underneath. So for all of you lefties out there, you just have to be a righty for the day. So first thing is really just kind of talking to your subject. For these measurements, most of them are going to be done kind of under the shirt. So we typically will ask our subject first if they mind taking their shirt off. It is possible to do measurements over clothing, but you will get a little bit of skewed results. So Grayson, do you mind removing your shirt for our measurements? So the first measurement that we're going to take is going to be the tricep. And so all of the measurements that we're going to do are going to be on the right side of the subject's body. So just make sure you're always using the subject's right side of the body. Even when you turn them to and from, it's not your right side, because if they face, you know, towards you versus away, it will change. So we're going to start with Grayson's right side. And for the tricep, this is actually one where we are going to measure with a measuring tape. So the location for the tricep is going to be halfway between the acromion and the olecranon process. So basically the end of your shoulder here and your elbow. So what I'm going to do is measure from the top of the shoulder to the elbow and find the halfway point. So we're right at 16. Now, typically it helps to make a mark on the body so that when you go through and measure again, you don't have to measure a second time. So I'm gonna take that halfway point, put a measurement, and then when we measure the tricep, we really wanna measure it on the back of the arm, the actual tricep. So now I'm just gonna transfer this mark right to the back of the arm, and then we'll have you come back and see the side of it. All right, so we've measured the halfway point and we transfer it to the back of the tricep. Now, what we do is we're gonna end up measuring right where we put that mark. So I'm gonna grab the skin fold with my two fingers and I'm gonna grab above the mark so that when I put the caliper on, it's actually on this mark here. So I'm gonna grab and try to separate out the subcutaneous fat from the muscle. 17. All right, our next measurement is going to be the subscapular. So to find this, you're going to kind of find your subject's scapula, so their shoulder blade. So sometimes on here for Grayson, I can find it pretty easily, but some subjects you might not be able to. So a little trick that you can do is ask your subject to place their arm behind their back. And you notice when that happens, it kind of pops out the shoulder blade a little bit. So I can find the edge of that shoulder blade. So you can go ahead and relax now. And the shoulder blade kind of comes down and then back up. So we're gonna measure 1 inch away from this medial border of the scapula. Now you'll notice a little bit of difference measuring males versus females, or females are typically gonna have a sports bra on. And they tend to kind of come right down this region here too. So the spot where I wanna measure is actually right here underneath her bra. So kind of proper etiquette with doing this is first letting your subject know that you might have to move their sports bra a little bit. And the way to move it would just be down a little bit. What you don't wanna do is realize to get to that location, you don't wanna lift from the bottom up. We just wanna kind of slide down slightly. So is it okay if I slide your sports bra down a little bit?
Yeah.
Okay. So I found that area. I'm gonna come down about an inch. And this is gonna be a diagonal measurement. And relax. All right, so another measurement that we have is going to be the chest, and this is also going to be a diagonal fold. And so this is the only one that varies slightly between a male and a female, where for males, you're going to measure halfway, or you're going to go halfway between the nipple and the armpit, or the crease of the armpit. For the females, you're gonna go a little bit higher. You're only gonna go about a third of the way and closer towards the armpit. Now this one you can typically just eyeball, and also we have the issue of the sports bra being in the way as well. So this is another one where you may not have to necessarily move it, but you're just gonna let your subject know where you're measuring. So I'm just gonna be grabbing on the side of your armpit right about here. So we're just gonna measure close to kind of the armpit here, and it's a diagonal fold, pulling away the skin and the subcutaneous fat from the muscle. And flex. Okay, so for the midaxillary measurement, this is gonna be on your midaxillary line, so that means in the middle of your armpit coming down. So if you had a shirt on, you could see it's kind of the line of your shirt, but for measurements, we obviously don't have your shirt on. So it's gonna come straight down from your armpit, and where we're actually gonna take that measurement is across from the subject's xiphoid process, the end of their sternum right there. So once again, for a female, we actually have the sports bra as almost a marker for there, because they typically sit right where your xiphoid process is, and it comes right across here to your midaxillary. So what I'm gonna do is first be able to get to the region, because when you're standing there, your arm is down. So kind of we have a couple options. Grayson, you could either put your arm kind of in front of you like this, or you can kind of put it behind you a little bit this way, whatever's more comfortable. What we wanna avoid is having your subject kind of put their arm up and stretch, and that'll just displace the skin a little bit. So this is perfect. I can get to the region, she's not stretched out. So coming straight down from her armpit, right across from the xiphoid process. You may, to pinch, need to move the bra a little bit up, so I'm just gonna move this up a little bit if that's okay. A vertical fold. All right, so for this measurement, we're gonna do the supra-iliac. So we're talking about your iliac crest on your hip, and supra is just above it. So we're gonna try to locate that iliac crest. And it actually helps if you have your subject help you out, because sometimes you can't tell maybe where their hip is, and you don't wanna be poking and prodding. Sometimes people just have really high hips that you can't really tell by looking at them. So Grayson, if you could find your hip bone for me, great. So here's the top of her iliac crest. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna measure 1 inch above the iliac crest, and this is gonna be a diagonal fold. And so we wanna still have it in the front of the body. We don't wanna have it right here on the back. So it's this front, this iliac crest, this diagonal. And we'll go about an inch above. So our next measurement is gonna be abdomen. So this one's pretty simple. It's just gonna be 1 inch to the right of the subject's navel. So just find the belly button. We're gonna get a 1 inch to the right. So I'm gonna grab top. Sometimes I kind of get down, but. So for our last measurement for the thigh, this is gonna be the second one where we actually are gonna physically locate the halfway point, just because it's a larger area to measure. So this is gonna be on your subject's right thigh, and it's gonna be halfway between the inguinal crease, which is kind of the groin here, and the top of the patella, which is the kneecap. So what I'm gonna actually do is have Grayson help me out. Just want you to kind of lift your leg up a little bit, and that way I can just kind of find the crease of where, of her leg. So now you can go ahead and put it down. And I'm actually gonna have you hold the measuring tape right there. Halfway point, 44, 22. And we're just gonna mark that halfway point. So once again, you don't have to go back your second and third time through and actually measure it. One time is good enough. And so the thigh, I think, is one of the trickiest measurements to do on a subject. The body fat really varies per person, but sometimes it's kind of harder to pull that skin away from the thigh. One thing you can do is kind of have your subject kind of rest most of their body weight on their left leg, and so that this one is just kind of slightly supported on the ground. So I'm gonna once again measure above. And this one you might have to pull a little bit more and actually pinch your subject to get that measurement. And on females, this is typically going to be one of the higher numbers for body composition. Now we're gonna do a waist circumference measurement. So we're gonna have a measuring tape, and we want it to be a spring-loaded tape so that we can have some tension while we're doing this measurement. Inches or centimeters, doesn't matter, depends what your chart is in. We're just gonna do this in inches. And so where you're gonna measure for the waist circumference is gonna be between the ribs and the hips, whatever part of your subject is smallest. And that will vary depending on person. So sometimes it may be, for example, Grayson right in here is where she's smallest, but for somebody else, it may be higher or lower. So this is one where you'll have to adjust it depending on body type. So I'm going to, if you can hold that with your hand, I'm actually gonna kind of walk around her to first do this so I don't have to give her a hug and possibly make it uncomfortable. Great, so now you can go ahead and relax. And so we're just gonna hold the tape together and put a little bit of tension on and see where the number zero, where it crosses the next line. Just make sure too that for some of these measurements that zero doesn't always start right here at the end. Make sure you see where it actually starts as your starting point. And then we get a measurement. So another way to do a measurement, I showed before how you could have the subject hold it and you kind of walk around them. Another way is to open this up and kind of put it over the subject, kind of like they're jumping rope, and put it over your subject, and then you have the tape to go around. And as we said before, you're gonna pick whatever spot is smallest on the subject. Now, if you're not able to tell, or maybe the person is just kind of straight down, you can actually take kind of multiple measurements, kind of a high, medium, and low one, and see whichever one ends up being the smallest, and then that's the measurement you would go with. Well, thank you for joining us for our little demonstration with skin folds and for waist circumference.
Bye.
Thank you, Grayson, for being our lovely subject.